guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited. This is my first tutorial of 2016. So I hope you all had a fabulous New Year's and happy holidays and all that good stuff. I don't want to make this intro super duper long. So straight to the point. This is the look that I'm going to be doing for you guys today. It's just a super bronze, kind of cranberry, warm, smoky eye, but it's totally doable for like an everyday kind of look. Sorry, people are like texting me. But you do whatever you're comfortable with. It's easy to recreate with other products. You don't necessarily need all of the eyeshadows and products that I used in this tutorial. They're totally easy to recreate with other colors or other brands, you know what I'm saying. I just wanted to go with a more dramatic lash and a more dramatic eyeliner. You don't have to. You guys can totally just put on some mascara, go out, call it a day, and it will still look amazing. But anyways, so I feel like I'm just rambling, so I'm just gonna end the intro. If you guys are not already subscribed to my channel, please do so. I would greatly appreciate it. Also, follow me on all of my social media platforms, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook. I will have that all listed down below, as well as every single product that I use today. And yeah, so I hope you guys love this tutorial. I really like the way it came out, and let's get started. Okay guys, so starting off, I'm going to go ahead and take my e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer. If you are super dry like I am, I totally would recommend giving this primer a try. My skin has been so much better. Like, so much better since I bought this primer, and it makes my makeup last all day. So next, for foundation, I'm taking my Maybelline Dream Wonder Liquid Foundation. I'm in the shade 120 Classic Ivory, and I just flopped this all over my face. This was the first time I used this foundation, so if I'm using it incorrectly, I apologize. I have to say, I wasn't too big of a fan just because I prefer more of a heavy coverage foundation. This is a little bit more sheer for my liking, but the way it sits and looks when it's done, I actually really liked. So I'm a little bit torn if I really like it or if I don't, so we shall see. But I'm just using a foundation buffing brush to buff this into my skin and make it blend seamlessly. So once I have this all buffed out, I am going to go ahead and take my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, and I'm in the shade 120, I'm in the shade Fair for concealer. And I just place this all under my lower eye area, and then I will go back in and place it in my T-zone as well. And I just blended it out with my fingers underneath my eyes. But I place it in my T-zone a little bit more just because, like I said, I like more of a heavy coverage foundation. So I just wanted to conceal that area a little bit more. And I just use my foundation brush to buff that in and make it blend out seamlessly. So to set everything, I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me Pressed Powder. I'm using the Set and Smooth line rather than what I've used in the past, just because this one is made for normal to dry skin, so I figured I would give it a try. So I just go ahead and blend this all over my skin just to make everything sit and stay all day long. And then I take my Tarte bronzer, which is almost gone. I'm so sad. This is the Park Avenue Princess bronzer, and I am going to just bronze my skin with this big buffing brush, face brush. And then for contour, I'm going to use this brown shade from the Wet n Wild contour palette. I believe they will be released sometime this year. I'm not sure when the release date is, but I just take that on an angled face brush, and I will place my powder wherever I want that contour, so I look funny for a moment. But yeah, so I just place that where I'm going to want it, which is cheekbones, temples, top of my face, and my jawbone. And then what's left on my brush, I will just go ahead and kind of blend onto my nose. And then I take a flat face brush to blend out that contour. I have been doing this for maybe a week now, and I've been obsessed with the way it makes everything look. It looks so natural, and I absolutely love it. So for brows, I'm going to use this Wet n Wild Ultimate Brow Kit, and I'm kind of speeding through it just because I do my brows all the time, and it's just a powder that I use. And I'm using the second shade in the brow kit, which is just a matte medium brown. And I use a spoolie to brush out my brows, and then I take an angle brush and go in and fill in my brows. And then I will go back in with a spoolie just to blend out that powder a little bit more. So once I have that all buffed out and ready to go, I take my Maybelline Fit Me concealer again, and I'm using this as a primer today for my eye for my eyeshadows. I almost said eyelashes. And I'm just going to use my finger to blend this out on my eyelid, and I take it underneath my lower lash line and in my inner corner as well. So once I have that all blended, the first color I'm going to use is actually from a kit that I got when I was in school. So I don't know what the brand is, and I don't know what color it is in, but any shade that is like one shade darker than your skin tone is what you want to use. And I'm just going to take that on a very fluffy brush and kind of just blend this all over my entire eye area. I am using the Luxie 205 tapered blending brush, and I'm just going to blend this, like I said, all over that eye area so it will make it easier to blend out the other shadows. So this first shadow I'm using is in Bright Copper. It's by Coastal Scents. And all four of these shades that I will be using on my eyes today are from their Fall Festival palette. But you can also buy them individually on coastalscents.com. So I take this on a more kind of pristine blending brush, and I'm just going to blend that into my crease, and this is going to be the first crease color. This color is just a very shimmery, kind of mauvey brown, is the best way to explain it. It's just such a pretty color. So for my second shade, I'm using this more kind of red purpley shade, and it's in the shade American Rose. And I'm taking a more kind of dense crease brush, and I will start on my outer corner making a little like little circles, and then I will kind of flick it and bring it into the rest of my crease. Once I have it pretty much in and the product off of my brush, I will go back in just doing windshield wiper motions and little circles to blend it and make sure it kind of blends seamlessly. That's all this eye look really is. It's just blending. Sorry, I lost my train of thought there for a second. So once I have those shades on my eye, on my crease and on my eye, I will go in back with the first color, Bright Copper, and go on top of American Rose just to blend them out together a little bit more. And then to blend them a little bit more, make sure there's no more harsh lines, I will go back in with that first color that I put all over my eyelid for a transition color. And this really just with any color or with any eye look, I do this all the time because I feel like it just really cleans up the entire look. There's no harsh lines and everything just seems to blend perfectly when I do this technique. So next I'm taking this dark purple. It has a little bit of shimmery red in it, and it's in Raisin Berry. And I take that more on a pencil brush, and I will a fluffy pencil brush, and I place this in the outer corner because I kind of just want to intensify that outer corner and make it a little more defined. I will slowly bring it into my crease, but more as a fading and ombre kind of aspect. And all I'm doing is windshield wiper motions and little circles. Just blend, 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 like I keep saying. You're going to keep blending until your hand falls off for this entire look. So for some reason, my camera cut out when I went to put my lid shade on. So my lid shade is in Light Apricot, and I just packed this onto my lid itself using a flat shader brush. So I went off camera and applied my eyeliner and my lashes. My liner is the e.l.f. Cream Eyeliner in black, and I just did a very dramatic winged eyeliner. And then my lashes are the Demi Wispies by Ardell, but I doubled them just so it looks a lot more full. And then for highlighting right now, I'm taking the highlighting shade, which is just a very light matte pink shade from the Wet n Wild Ultimate Brow Kit, and I place it under my brow bone as well as on my inner corner. And also when my camera cut out, I did take every eyeshadow that we used on our lid underneath my lower lash line. So for my cheeks, I'm using this kind of mauve natural kind of. It's really hard to explain the color. I just don't have a blush like it, and it's the only one I know of. I don't know why there's music playing all of a sudden, so give me one second. Okay, sorry about that. So yeah, I just take this blush and I'm using a blush brush and just placing this on the apples of my cheeks and blending it back towards my hairline. And I just love the way this blush looks. Like I said, it's super natural. And because our eyes were super dramatic, I didn't want anything crazy on my cheeks. For highlight, I'm using an Ulta highlighter. It's a natural highlight, and I have been obsessed with this highlighter since I got it for Christmas. And I mean obsessed. So I'm just placing this on the tops of my cheekbones. And honestly, this highlight I just feel like makes anybody look like a porcelain doll. Like it just adds a nice gleam. Not a shimmer, not like some crazy highlight, just a nice gleam and glowing face. So for lips, I'm going to overline the hell out of my lips and just make them very plump and luscious. I'm using Ofra Cosmetics lip liner in the shade Spicy, and this is just a very nude kind of brown shade. If you're not comfortable overlining your lips, you do not have to for this look. That's just something I wanted to do. This look is also very suitable to match any other kind of lip color you are comfortable wearing. So once I line my lips, I will go back in and fill them in with this lip liner just as a base for my lipstick. And then my lipstick I am using is by The Balm, and it's their Meet Matte Hues liquid lipstick in the shade Committed. And I just place this all over the tops of my lip, on the top of my lips, and that is the look. So thank you guys for watching. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please do so, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!